since all powers agree that there must be disarmament under effective international control, there can be no disarmament without control, and no control without disarmament, but only disarmament with control, and only control with disarmament. One cannot be exclusive of the other, nor can there be any question of priority of one over the other. This is indeed so elementary and so self-evident that the Prime Minister Nehru rightly said in his address before the Plenary General Assembly, I quote, "It seems very extraordinary that great nations should argue about priorities in this matter and make that a reason for not going ahead," end of the quotation. Let us now end this futile and senseless argument. Since we all agree that the process of disarmament must be under international control, let us all recognize the inexorable conclusion that disarmament and control must go together, that they must be accepted concurrently, that they must be implemented concurrently. Let us then go on from there. Mr. Chairman, in fact, our sole preoccupation at this juncture should be with bringing about the acceptance of concrete proposals on disarmament and concrete proposals on control.